Three best ways to animate mouth in Alight Motion. There are many ways to animate mouths, but these three are the most used ones and also are the ones I find to be the best. Do not worry, they are pretty easy. Choppy. Let's animate a hi. Import the audio in Alight Motion through audio.
Hi.
Look at the pronunciation guide and try pronouncing it and seeing how your mouth moves. Now, upon our observation, we'll import the mouth we need. Tap on the plus, then go to Media, then tap on the View All button. Then tap on Multiple Layer Selection and select the layers. You'll find two of these Add buttons here. This one sorts the layers on top of one another, while this one sorts after one layer has ended. The duration of the layer will be the duration you set here. I'll use the first add. I have imported three mouths, the closed mouth, the open mouth, and smiley. Tap on the layer and you'll find the buttons for trim left, split, and trim right. Use them for trimming and splitting the layers. And also move the timeline by a millisecond, one frame, before trimming the next layer or they'll overlap.
Hi! Hi! Hi!
Tap and hold a layer to move it around in the timeline. Or you can go to the frame you want to place the layer in and tap on the Move to Frame button. Using these tools, we can make our mouth animation or lip sync. You can use bookmarking to mark the timeline. Tap on the 000000 to bookmark the frame. Then you can easily move across several bookmarks using just the arrows. And make sure the mouths are level in one place. Smooth and bouncy. Carry out the process of choppy because we'll be using it and adding motion to it.
Hi!
Tap on the layer and go to Move and Transform, and then you'll find Location, Rotation, Scale, Skew. Keyframe, Animation Easing, Reset Options. Tap on the location symbol to activate Pivot Point. The pivot point is a point around where the object or layer moves. Make sure the pivot point is in the middle or the center for all the layers. Then go to Scale and enable Freestyle Scale. Add a keyframe at the middle of the layer. A keyframe will be automatically added when you adjust the scale. No need to do this. Move to the beginning of the layer and make the layer thinner. Then move to the end of the layer and thin it as well.
Hi!
If you have a longer clip, then take the layer, then add keyframes at the start and a few milliseconds after the starting. And the same for the end part. But if there are no layers after, then you don't need to add two keyframes at the end. Thin the mouth for bounce at the start. And you can thin it slightly at the end for a nice extra bounce. You can just add a little scale for the closed mouth, just before or after it starts moving.
Hi! Hi!
Tap on the animation easing. Use the ease out easing in the first part and ease in the second part. We are adding the easing at the starting and the ending animation of the layer. Do this for all the layers.
Hi. Hi.
You can use custom easings as well.
Hi.
Also, you can tweak it too. You can add more rotation and slow zoom, etc.
Hi.
But this is the main thing to the little bouncy mouth movement.
Hi. Hi.
Extra smooth. This one is done in a completely different way. First, tap on the plus and add a vector drawing layer. Draw a line using 3 points, put a point in the middle as well. And then enable curve for the middle point. Then slightly bring it upwards. You can watch this tutorial for more information on vector drawing. This is what it looks with and without the curve. Go to color and fill and select the no media. Then go to border and shadows and enable stroke. You may position it using the move and transform, but make sure to have the pivot point in the middle of the line. Name this layer upper lip. Duplicate the upper lip and bring the middle point downwards. You can unlock the angle and direction to move one handle without moving the other. Make sure these 2 points of the lower lip look connected to these 2 points of the upper lip. Keep the pivot point at the top where the upper lip is. Rename it lower lip. Then add another vector drawing layer and construct the mouth using points and curve when necessary. This is supposed to fill the entire mouth. Close the path. Set a dark red color. Fix the layer ordering by holding on the 3 lines of the layer and then dragging it above or below. Bring back to the back. I call this the back since it is going to be the back of the mouth. Then add a circle and adjust the position and scale. This will be the tongue. Set the color to a light coral color. Bring the tongue layer right above the back layer. Tap on the overflow menu and select Create a Clipping Mask. Then add a rounded rectangle. This will be the upper teeth. Position it. Adjust the radius and bring the layer under the lips, set the color to white. Then tap on the overflow menu and select Convert to Outline. And create a clipping mask. Then you can adjust the teeth as you like. I'll make it slightly more curved at the middle. If you want to add sharper teeth or fangs, you can add a contour and then draw it. Contours are layers in other words. Then name it upper teeth. Duplicate and adjust for the lower teeth so make slight changes. If you curve the upper teeth, curve the lower teeth in such a way that they won't look odd or overlap while still closing the gap or having a reduced gap. Oh, and if you're having trouble drawing them, you can import a picture of the mouth and trace it or use it as a guide. If you're satisfied with the setup and want to use this mouth again, you can select all the layers and group them. Then name the group and tap on the overflow menu and select Save to My Elements. This will then become an importable and editable element and can be imported from here. Now let's animate.
Hi!
I brought the audio and now let's bookmark the parts where we want the mouth shape to change. Use location to position the lips, teeth, and tongue. Add keyframes to animate. Do you remember keeping the pivot point of the lower lip at the top? Now if you use Y or height scale, it'll thin one looking connected to the upper lip as long as they are following the same location. Make sure to animate the back according to the lips or the mouth shape. The back needs to fill the mouth properly. The teeth just usually requires only location for animation. To animate the points, go to Edit Points and then switch to Keyframe Editing mode. Now we find our baby's keyframe and animation easing. Add keyframes and move points however you want. When making a closed mouth shape, make sure the lines are as close as possible.
Hi! Hi!
If there are any errors, fix them.
Hi! Hi!
You can animate the mouth group, add more motions and easings. It's easier since you're animating it as a whole. You can edit it to make the mouth more front-facing or side-facing in animation too. You can use or trace the shape of the gacha mouths. It's fine, I do and did it too. If the mouth needs to be adjusted, adjust it. Copy the mouth group and delete it. Then select the head group, tap on Edit Group, and paste the copied mouth group. Now if you rotate the head, the mouth will also move with the head in place. Doesn't matter if it turns out bad, with more practice and experimentation, it'll get better and better.